Hey everybody, this is Rob Wilson with Prepare to Perform and Performance Therapeutics here with my wife Tommy at CrossFit Virginia Beach, and we're going to show you how to do a jumping negative pull-up. And the idea here is that a lot of times the hardest part of the pull-up is the up part, right, because you're working against gravity. So what we're going to do is use a jump assist to get to the top and then control the descent of the pull-up, right, and that really helps us build some strength in the upper body while we're working on our skill progression. So, for the pull-ups, we're gonna have our hands facing away from our face with thumbs around. We're gonna bend our knees, go all the way down to the bottom of the pull-up position, so that means open shoulder, locked out elbow, and then we're gonna jump to the top and hold, and then control the descent back to a locked out position before we place our feet on the support. Okay, so it's really important to strengthen through the full range of motion. If you stop short with your elbow and put your feet down, it really doesn't go a long way to helping you develop strength throughout the full range of motion. Okay. Now, if we're going to do the chin-up variation, you want to make sure that your palms are facing you. Another important thing about jumping negatives is to pay attention in the programming to the ratio of hold at the top to descent. All right. These do have potential to do a lot of muscle damage. All right. So you want to be able to recover from it properly, so it's important to follow the amount of time that we descend. So for example, if we're doing a jumping negative and it's a hold one at the top with a 2 second descent, it'll look like this. So we have palms away in the pull-up position, bent knees, locked down the bottom. We jump, one, and then down, one, two, and then feet down. All right, so it's really important to follow the ratio that's given